You know, in our digital world, it's impossible for women and girls to escape messaging and images about beauty and body image as well. So often those messages are focused on outward appearance rather than authentic beauty inward, all that beauty. It's our next guest's mission to expand and redefine what beauty means through her blog, podcast, and brand new book. Melissa Johnson is a marriage and family therapist, a Bethel professor, and the author of this brand new book, which is called Soul Deep Beauty, Fighting for Our True Worth in a World Demanding Flawless. Those are a lot of words, and that's exactly what's happening. I have a 17-year-old, almost 17-year-old, her group of friends, just this beautiful group of friends, and I just think that that is their challenge of trying to avoid what is being bombarded to them every single moment of the day. Yes. Not what you and I grew up with, right? And you're much younger than me, not what you and I grew up with, right?
Well, right, but it was even a struggle back then. I mean, thinking about, I think back in the 2000s, it was called like heroin chic to be so thin that it looked like you were, you know, were on heroin. And so I think this idea of unrealistic beauty ideals has been around for a while, but I do think that we are getting, well, there's this documentary called The Illusionist that talks about we're at the point of media saturation where 80% of our waking hours we're exposed to some kind of media. And so when we think about what a struggle it was for you and I probably growing up, but now more so when the up and coming generations are inundated by social media, but also us who are, you know, every day going through, you know, billboards and movies and television, these unrealistic beauty standards that we are literally being brainwashed, I think, with and inundated with.
So what do you do? What are some steps that parents can do? What are people that have maybe, you know, a 5-year-old girl at home, 7-year-old girl? I heard lately that is just crazy to me that there are kids that are in, let's say, a beauty store 10, 11 years old, wanting to buy, you know, a refrigerator for their cosmetics. They're getting Botox at 18 because it's going to prevent wrinkles. I mean, there's so many crazy messages coming through to them that they truly believe.
Yes. And the beauty industry and cosmetic industry is like increasing its profits all the time. I think the last I heard, there's actually a makeup line or skincare line for like toddlers now.
No.
And yeah, I was shocked. A couple weeks ago, I just heard that. And so what can we do? So first of all, I think we can have spread this idea of media literacy. So becoming more conscientious of what we're consuming. And also, instead of getting caught up in the emotional matrix that I think oftentimes advertising invites us to do, to make us feel shame, to make us feel poorly about our bodies, about our faces or whatever perceived imperfection we have, we can become aware that they are trying to sell us a product, and the shame they're perpetuating is very much on purpose to sell us something. And so I think if we can become more savvy consumers of media, I think we can also become aware of what's known as diet culture, this idea that we should change or shrink our bodies in order to gain social acceptance, in order to become more like healthy, and also to gain morality. We have this, all of these ties to thinness in our culture that I think is really harmful. So I think we can become aware of that.
And then you have to be really careful as the mom or the grandma or the aunt or whoever the female person in the household, the older female person in the household, that you use the right words. You're talking about being strong, yeah, being healthy, being, you know, vibrant. Keep the girls in sports. Keep the girls busy, yeah, doing sports and reading and acting and dancing and all the other things that keep them away from their phone as much as possible.
Yes, yes.
Right?
Yes, and affirming all those things. I think it's great to tell a girl that they're beautiful, and I think there are so many other like characterological things that we can highlight and tell them, you know, how kind and how strong they are. And so I think we can spend more time there as well.
Mm-hmm. And that's what you kind of dive deep into in this book that you just wrote.
Yes, yes. So like the first half is all about this idea of awareness, opening our eyes to these lies about beauty that we've been sold so that we can shed those ideas and we can move into a new, deeper, truer idea of beauty that I'm redefining as the life of God at work in us and among us.
I love that. Mm-hmm. Well, and it's, you know what, it's a really good read for all the moms out there, all the people mm-hmm. that are trying to raise these girls and boys too, really.
Yes.
So it's such a good idea. So this book's available everywhere, I understand?
Yes, yes.
Congratulations on that.
Thank you so much.
And thanks for coming in the show and helping us understand that and really understanding the steps to working through this. We have a link to the Impossible Beauty blog and the podcast, and of course the book, again, is called Soul Deep Beauty by Melissa Johnson, and it is available everywhere that books are sold. Well, coming up next.